Hey guys, it's Peter, and welcome to my channel, Peterisms, where I tell stories of my life and just little things that I've learned as I have grown into the person that I am today. And I wanted to do something a little bit different on this channel today. I have been having the most fantastic day. It is so beautiful outside. The clouds literally look like cotton balls, just like hanging out amongst the blue. And it's 79 degrees in Indianapolis. I've got my coffee. I've been driving around listening to music. It's just been such a great day. And so many people have been asking me to take this 16 personalities test. You guys know what it is. It's very similar to the Myers-Briggs. And I think it's based on that, or it is that. I don't know. But a couple days ago, I went in and I took it, and I was like, I'm going to do this for a video, and because I know, typically on Fridays, I do Dear Peter videos, which is where I come in and I give advice based on an email that I make. So if you guys have advice questions that you want me to answer, please email the email below at Dear, and put in the subject line Dear Peter so that I know that that's what it's about. Part of the problem is that I get very, very serious requests for advice, and all of the advice I give on this channel is just is based on personal experience. It's not, you know, any kind of expert advice or professional advice or anything like that. So I try to make those videos about things that aren't so serious, if that makes sense. And if people need, I don't know, more serious advice or more professional guidance, to seek that out, you know, with the help of a professional therapist or doctor or life coach or counselor or something like that. So anyway, I wanted to do this test for one reason, because I wanted to find out. I couldn't remember what I was. I had taken it years ago with a team of people that I worked with. And then I knew that it had like changed over time, and they had added like new pieces and all this kind of stuff. So a couple people had asked me in the comment sections of this channel and my vlog to make videos about it. So I was like, okay, well, I'm gonna make a video about this. And it was funny because I was like, I hadn't gone to like, so if you guys don't know, I have a merch shop now. It's linked below. And just t-shirts and crap like that. If you wanna see it, go have at it. But anyway, I was like looking at that, and then I was like, oh, I have to do that 16 personalities test. So while I was doing that late at night, I just went in there and I took the test. It says it takes like 12 to 20 minutes to take, but it took me, I think, like less than 10 minutes to take. I will link the website below. This is not sponsored. I don't get anything from it. Just go take it. It's fun to see, you know. The thing about it is that it doesn't really tell you like how you would work better with other types, if that makes sense. Like, when I did it with the team that I worked with, we had like a professional, like, you know, person that came in and like knew about the test and said, oh, well, you would work best with these kind of people, right? If that makes sense. Because you wouldn't want to have a group of all of the same kind of people, because the group wouldn't work that way. And wouldn't work well that way. And actually, teams, if I remember this correctly, work better when they have different kind of diverse personalities within the population. Within the population. Within the group, if that makes sense. So, without further ado, let's get into my results of the 16 personalities test. So, I had the results emailed to me, but I'm going to read you what it said first. So, my test results. Personality type, the mediator. I am a INFP/T, okay? And it says my individual traits, introverted, 57%, intuitive, 74%, feeling, 76%, prospecting, 51%, turbulent, 74%, role, diplomat, strategy, constant improvement. Now, one of the things that it says in there is be completely honest with your answers. I was like completely honest with my answers. Like for each question, I was like, okay, now really think about this. And there are questions like, you know, like do you like to go up to somebody and shake their hand and things like that. It's, they're all based on like social interactions and stuff like that. Dreaming, passion, things like that. So I think for you to get the, you know, results that you want to get, you have to be like, not answer it the way that you would, you know, want other people to think of you, but you answer it the way that you're, you know, you really believe that that makes sense. So I went in here and I got my results. So let's go in here and find out a little bit about, I'm not going to read the whole thing because it is literally like 9 pages long and of what the mediator is, but I'll just read the beginning of it. INFP personality, the mediator. INFP personalities, we'll see. Now, I haven't read any of this, okay? So we'll see how true this is to who I am. I guess I'm the only one that will really know that. I don't know. You guys, you watch me every day, so I guess you will too. INFP personalities are true idealists, always looking for the hint of good and even the worst of people and events, searching for ways to make things better. While they may be perceived as calm, reserved, or even shy, INFPs have an inner flame and passion that can truly shine. Comprising just 4% of the population, the risk of feeling misunderstood is unfortunately high for the INFP personality type, but when they find like-minded people to spend their time with, the harmony they feel will be a fountain of joy and inspiration. Okay, so that's really interesting. So basically what it's saying is, you know, that like, to some degree I'm introverted and that like, you know, I'm always on the lookout for like tribes of people that think like me. And I would agree with that when it comes to like passions and creativity and things like that. Like as soon as I find somebody that I feel like has like interests, like I feel very connected to them. But it isn't something that I find very often. And so I keep my circle pretty close, if that makes sense. Okay. Being a part of the diplomat personality group, INFPs are guided by their principles rather than by logic. Excitement, explorers, or practicality, sentinels. When deciding how to move forward, they will look to honor, beauty, morality, and virtue. INFPs are led by the purity of their intent, not rewards and punishments. People who share the INFP personality type are proud of this quality, and rightly so, but not everyone understands the drive behind these feelings, and it can lead to isolation. Yeah, and I think that's something that I talk about. I mean, none of this is like really a surprise. This is something that I talk about like in literally all of my videos, right? Is about remaining teachable and, you know, not giving your integrity away and things like that. I would also say that for me, like, I'm not the person I was 20 years ago. I mean, I feel like I'm constantly growing. Do I make mistakes? I make mistakes all the time, you know? Do I make mistakes in interactions with people? All the time, you know? But I think that it's about looking at what the morals are inside. I mean, to say that you're led by your morals doesn't mean that you are like the perfection of morality. I think that needs to be said. What it means is that you're constantly trying to improve upon yourself or apologize for mistakes that you've made or mend fences, things like that, you know, or, you know, learn from the experiences that you've had in your life to become a better version of yourself. And I think that is what I try to do on a regular basis. I think that's what I've tried to do ever since I got sober. Before that, I bet I probably would score a completely different score. We know what we are, but not what we may be. At their best, these qualities enable INFPs to communicate deeply with others, easily speaking in metaphors and parables, and understanding and creating symbols to share their ideas. The strength of this intuitive communication style lends itself well to creative works, and it comes as no surprise that many INFPs are poets, writers, and actors. Understanding themselves and their place in the world is important to INFPs, and they explore these ideas by projecting themselves into their work. INFPs have a talent for self-expression, a revealing their beauty and their secrets through metaphors and fictional characters. INFP's ability with language doesn't stop with their native tongue either. As with most people who share the diplomat personality types, they are considered gifted when it comes to learning a second or third language. Now we know that's a lie straight from the pit of hell. I can't learn a language to save my life. Their gift for communication also lends itself well to INFP's desire for harmony, a reoccurring theme with diplomats, and helps them to move forward as they find their calling. Listen to many people, but talk to few. Unlike their extroverted cousins, though, INFPs will focus their attention on just a few people. A single worthy cause, spread too thinly, they'll run out of energy and even become dejected and overwhelmed by all the bad in the world that they can't fix. This is a sad sight for INFPs friends who will come to depend on their rosy outlook. If they are not careful, INFPs can lose themselves in their quest for good and neglect the day-to-day upkeep that life demands. INFPs often drift into deep thought, enjoying contemplating the hypothetical and philosophical more than any other personality type. Left unchecked, INFPs may start to lose touch, withdrawing into hermit mode, and it can take a great deal of energy from their friends or partners to bring them back into the world, or into the real world. Luckily, like the flowers in spring, INFPs' affection, creativity, altruism, and idealism will always come back, rewarding them and those they love, perhaps not with logic and utility, but with a worldview that inspires compassion, kindness, and beauty wherever they go. And I think that's true. I think, like, you know, I don't go into becoming, you know, a recluse as much as I used to. Does it still happen from time to time? Absolutely. My best friend Tanya is very, very good at pulling me out of that. She'll say like, now you've been at home for 4 nights. You need to like, come on, let's go. And I think it's also about feeling very safe in my own small world and having, you know, social anxiety and things like that. That like, if I go outside, like I'm, you know, even if it, even just like going outside to trust my friends or trust other people, like sometimes I have a hard time with that. So yeah, I'd agree with that. Mediators, you may know. So these are other people that scored the exact same thing that I did. William Shakespeare, J.R.R. Tolkien, Bjork, Johnny Depp, Julia Roberts, Lisa Kudrow, Tom Hiddleston, Alicia Keys, Frodo Baggins, The Lord of the Rings. That's interesting. Anna Green Gables, Fox Mulder from X-Files. I love that. Okay. Arwen, The Lord of the Rings, Sybil Branson from Downton Abbey, Lance Sweet from Bones. I don't, these are all fictional characters. And Constantine Levin from Anna Karenina. Anna Karenina. I never read it. Okay. So anyway, the next one goes to strengths and weaknesses. And I'm going to go to the bottom of this and see like what the next one is, because there might be something that might be more interesting than strengths and weaknesses. Romantic relationships. Let's see what the romantic relationship, what's after romantic relationships. I think there should be like a conclusion to all of this. Love all, trust a few, do wrong to none. I've done my fair share of wrong in the world, you know, a friendship. Let's see about this. INFP friends. The true friends of people with the INFP personality type tend to be few and far between, but those that make the cut are often friends for life. The challenge is the many dualities that this type harbors when it comes to being sociable. INFPs crave the depth of mental or mutual human understanding, but tire easily in social situations. They are excellent at reading into others' feelings and motivations, but are often unwilling to provide others the same insight into themselves. It's as though INFPs like the idea of human contact, but not the reality of social contact. That's totally true. You know, like, it's fun to talk about in the context, but like a lot of times, like I get very nervous, like interacting with other people. And I've talked about that a lot on here. And I think that that's the social anxiety part that I've like fought my entire life that really drugs and alcohol really helped me with a lot. Okay. And then it goes into finances, parenthood. Well, we know I'm not going to have children. So we can go on to the next one. Career paths. That's kind of boring. I want to see if there's like a conclusion. Workplace habits. See, this is where you do it as a team with other people. Oh, conclusion. Let's read the conclusion. INFP personality conclusion. Few personality types are as poetic and kind-hearted as INFPs. Now, you guys know that every single one of these results, like, has a really nice conclusion, okay? Any of them say that you're a real shit person, okay? Just so you know. Their altruism and vivid imagination allow INFPs to overcome many challenging obstacles, more often than not, brightening the lives of those around them. INFPs' creativity is invaluable in many areas, including their own personal growth. Yet INFPs can be easily tripped up in areas where idealism and altruism are more of a liability than an asset. That is very true. Whether it is finding or keeping a partner, making friends, reaching dazzling heights on the career ladder, or planning for the future, INFPs need to put in a conscious effort to develop their weaker traits and additional skills. What you have read so far is just an introduction into the complex concept that is the INFP personality type. You may have muttered to yourself, wow, this is so accurate, it's a little creepy. Or, finally, someone understands me. You may have even asked, how do they know more about me than the people I'm closest to? This is not a trick. You felt understood because you were. We've studied how INFPs think and what they do to reach their full potential. And no, we did not spy on you. Many of the challenges you faced and will face in the future have been overcome by other INFPs. You simply need to learn how they succeeded. But in order to do, this is where they're going to sell us on something. But in order to do that, you need to have a plan, a personal roadmap. The best car in the world will not take you to the right place if you do not know where you want to go. We have told you how INFPs tend to behave in certain circumstances and what their key strengths and weaknesses are. Now we need to go much deeper into your personality type and answer why, how, what if. Oh, and then you can buy their premium profile. Are you kidding me? No. And you didn't really tell me anything I didn't already know. But it was fun to take that test. There's all those kind of tests on the internet. Did you guys know that? I mean, not on the BuzzFeed test, because I love the BuzzFeed test. Like, which mean girl are you? But it's so funny, because every time I take that mean girls test, I always get Regina George. But then I was talking to some friends of mine at dinner, and every single one of them goes, I always get Regina George, so I don't know. But anyway, I love those BuzzFeed tests too. But there's all kinds of fun tests on the internet, and you know, you can take tests to see, like, if you have ADHD. What do you think I scored on that test? Off the charts. Anyway, so I will link it below. You guys can go check it out for yourself and have fun with it. It's a 16 personalities test, 16personalities.com. So if you are comfortable with it, leave in the comment section below if you took the test what you ended up scoring, and that would be interesting to see what everybody is. What if we were all INFPs? Wouldn't that be hilarious? Anyway, I love you guys, and I will see you later. Bye.